cookies. Cookies are small files that websites leave on your web browser. Cookies allow websites to remember users' behaviors and preferences on a given website. They enable a lot of the features that web users like. For example, cookies are what allow a website to remember whether or not you're logged in with your user account. Cookies also allow shopping websites to remember what items have been placed in a user's shopping cart. Furthermore, cookies are simple text files, so they can't contain any code that would run a program, and therefore they cannot execute malware infections on your computer. So cookies are great for convenience, and they are malware-free. But cookies have a downside, too. One particular kind of cookie, called a tracking cookie, can track user activity across the internet. Many users feel like tracking cookies are a violation of privacy. For example, if you shop for baseballs on baseballgear.com on Monday afternoon, you might notice that a new website starts showing you ads for baseball bats and gloves on Monday evening. These targeted ads imply that your behaviors are being observed and shared between websites and between different companies. This is made possible by tracking cookies. Tracking cookies are ultimately all about advertising. As you can imagine, advertisements are much more valuable if they're tailored towards your personal interests. The more targeted the ads are to you, the more effective the ad usually is. That's why advertisers advertise toys during children's shows and beer during football games. The people who are interested in children's TV shows are statistically more likely to be interested in toys, and the same people who are interested in football games are statistically more likely to be interested in beer. Tracking cookie companies pay websites to run software that writes tracking cookies onto your browser. These tracking cookies can collect information about you on any website that runs the software by the tracking cookie company. Over time, the tracking cookie company builds a profile on the user behavior associated with your web browser, and it can use that profile to direct targeted ads to your browser. It reads the cookie, it observes your browsing behavior, and it says to itself something like this: I see that you've been reading about baseballs and buying baseballs. I guess I should show you these baseball bat advertisements because it seems likely that you're the kind of person who'd be interested in buying a baseball bat. Another issue with cookies is that they can allow users to stay signed in to online accounts on their browsers. Now, on the face of it, there's no major issue here. Why would it matter if you stayed logged in on your own private computer? Well, it only becomes a problem if somebody is allowed to snoop through your computer. For example, you might leave your computer in a public place. Or, more likely, you might leave your computer out at home during a party or a gathering. Or, if your boyfriend or girlfriend has access to your computer, then they might have automatic access to your accounts. In any of these situations, somebody else could use your active login information to access your online accounts. So although cookies are more convenient for you, keep in mind that they're also more convenient for people who snoop through your computer. And of course, if you're using a public computer, then make sure that it does not remember the password for your online accounts. You don't want people in public to log into your private accounts. One final security issue with cookies. If you are using an unsecure wireless connection, then eavesdroppers can intercept cookies sent to and from your computer. If the cookie in question happens to be an authentication cookie that's used for logging into an online account, then the eavesdropper can save this cookie and use the information on it to log into your account later.